Welcome to Ramco TV. In a previous video, we gave you an overview of what overall equipment effectiveness is and why you should use it. In this video, we will be taking a look at the calculation itself and how you can utilize it to improve your processes. Let's take a look. The basis of the Oee calculation is as simple as it is brilliant. It assumes a theoretical maximum capacity on the one hand and the actual output on the other. The Oee calculation maps out the loss landscape clearly in a way that everyone can understand. The calculation poses these three questions. Is the machine operating or not? Availability. How fast is the machine running? Performance. How many products met the specifications? Quality. We start this calculation with availability. If the machine is producing product while it was available to the production team, we know that it was running. The availability rate indicates the relationship between the time that the machine could theoretically have been in production and the time that there was actual output. For example, if a machine delivers 360 minutes of output, regardless of the speed and quality during an 8-hour shift, which is 480 minutes, then the availability rate is 360 divided by 480, or 75%. In other words, 25% of the available time is lost. Oee now asks the second question of performance. Say that the machine is designed to produce 10 pieces a minute, in which case you would expect to have 3,600 pieces after 360 minutes, right? Of course, this is only possible if the machine performs while it is running at 100% speed. The performance rate determines whether this is true. In the performance rate, theoretical output is the output that the machine could have made in theory if the machine had operated at maximum speed during the time that it was actually operated. For example, the machine operates 360 minutes and the production speed is 10 pieces per minute. The theoretical output is 360 times 10, or 3,600 pieces. Actual output, which includes both good and rejected pieces, though, is only 2,880 pieces. So performance is 2,880 divided by 3,600, or 80%. So, when we know how long the machine ran and how fast it ran, the next question is quality. Once we have measured the time and speed losses, we focus our attention on the quality of the products that are being made. The relationship between the number of units produced and the number of units produced that meet the specifications is called the quality rate. For example, we know that during the production time, 2,880 pieces were produced, but 144 of those pieces were rejected, giving us a total of 2,736 good pieces. To calculate the quality rate, we take 2,736 divided by 2,880, which gives us 95%. When we line up the answers to the three questions, the total Oee calculation looks like this. The Oee is calculated by multiplying the availability rate by the performance rate by the quality rate. Availability rate is B divided by A, or 360 minutes divided by 480 minutes, which equals 75%. Performance rate is D divided by C, or 2,880 pieces divided by 3,600, which equals 80%. Quality rate is F divided by E, or 2,736 units divided by 2,880 units, which equals 95%. So the Oee is 75% times 80% times 95%, which gives us 57%. So, in this example, your machine is running at 57% overall equipment effectiveness. You can take this information and begin to look at options for improving availability, performance, or quality, and see how small changes can make a big difference in your overall equipment effectiveness. For additional information on Oee, or to speak with a specialist about options for improving your processes, give us a call or visit ramcoi.com. If you liked this video or found it helpful, be sure to give it a thumbs up. To get alerts about when we post new videos, be sure to hit the subscribe button and click the bell. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you next time on Ramco TV.